Hello and welcome back to Tharic Plays Mordheim, City of the Damned. Today I actually have to waste a day, if that makes sense. As you can see, Akmundur here is injured for 2 days, Lurch is learning for 2 days, and Pavel is learning for 3 days, which means I will not have 4 heroes. Or 2 and an impressive.
Shipment request arrived.
Oh, we've got a shipment request. So before I advance one more day, though, on Julian here, although I can't. He's got 2 skill points left. I think I need for him to wait to level up, which he's close to again. And then we can do that. So I misspoke, maybe. 255 in weight. That's not too bad. We can do that right away. Wow, I even overshoot it with that. So let's end that. So that's already taken care of. But since we're already at it, I might as well. So I need 176 in terms of reputation here. 176 like this.
You are getting noticed.
Okay. There we go. And that brings that up to 3. So what did I get for that? 1 additional day to fulfill Wordstone requests. I don't care too much. And an enchantment pack regular. Okay. Let's see. Cutthroat's Den, Black Pit Settlement. I could send off more, but it's in this case, it's not that much Wordstone, so it's probably not worth it. And now we're going to advance one day because we need to.
New hired swords are available.
Okay, and now we can get going again. Yeah, and I'm gonna keep learning skills for Lurch. We will get him back in soon, I think, but we're not quite there yet. Let's go for some scouts. And it's, as always with the Impressive, they tend to really, at least for me, oh god, I don't want to do that again. But we're gonna, yeah, sure. They keep to really collect skill points because you get them in late, so you use them for a long time before they, at least I do, until they start to overtake your heroes, and then you start to shuffle them out again so that they don't just level up too quickly. So I went with the Haunter in the Darkness again. I already did that and regretted it to no end a while ago. Okay, it's another undead warband, and literally 7 of them act before I get to do anything. The map appears to be a little bit more forgiving, though, than the previous one, maybe. This I do not like, although we do have access to this, so I will be able to get in there. And that guy does not have another arm. And he did something that gave me a free dodge attempt. I don't remember. It's Daredevil, I think, is the skill that does that. And this, he's the one that is in the biggest danger, I believe, because he's alone on the second floor of this building, or the first floor, depending on where you are geographically. In Europe, it would be the first floor, I believe, at least in Germany it is, because you've got the ground floor, then you've got the first floor, while in America, I believe, the ground floor is the first floor, so it would be the second floor. Don't know why there's a difference there, but there is. So yeah, I went with this mission again, even though last time I regretted doing this. Let's see if that's the case this time as well. So far, I'm not a fan. Their initiative makes me even less of a fan of this entire setup. But I wanted to do a good mission, of course, and it would have been an easier one instead. Oh, come on, by 1%. It would have been only a hard one at the best in that case, and it's been a long time since I've done just a hard one, if you can call that just. But I like doing these harder missions now. I enjoy it. It also gives us more experience, though the overall development is quicker At least in theory. Let's see if she can hit with her charge. Damn. This I do like. There is one enemy over there who looks like he's on fire, although he isn't. Is that an enemy? Yes, it is. That should not be an issue, though. We can kill this guy, hopefully, fairly easily and quickly. He will not get... Ideally, he will not get any support before that happens. Okay, he just needs to jump down there, apparently. Can I get in there as well? No, wow, okay, this is quite the nuisance. I could have jumped down there again, but I think this, it basically comes down to more or less the same. Either way, we won't quite get in there. Yeah, okay, so, ooh, another one with a bow. Overwatch up there, that's a bummer. Oh, come on, why does... I mean, I'm... The scattered and scared is one thing. The game deciding, hey, I'm gonna put all your zombies in high places where you will take forever to move them down because they're freaking slow. That I have an issue with. That is not nice. Oh boy, yeah, I'm surrounded by interesting stuff here, apparently. And I will get potentially Overwatch shotted. Is that their cart? That is their cart. Okay, we're gonna steal their idol. Assuming I can get there. Oh, there's an enemy. Oh, nice, we can get there. He's not in a good spot. I wouldn't have been able to get very far anyways, and this way at least he is doing something useful. And it drops their morale right away. It's just a matter of him actually surviving to keep their round. Oh, come on. Yeah, we're not looking too good in these areas, and especially if he makes his dodges. It's not nice. I'm not dealing too much damage to begin with. Okay. I could disengage and try to run away, but I don't think I would make it very far. Yeah, I'm just gonna parry. Let's see, now we've got the all-alone check over there. Fails it, good. That's free damage for us. Catching him again might be a nuisance, but it's still better than the alternative, I think. How far does he go? Too far. Way too far. Could you stop? There is worse down here, but we can't afford to take that. I need to move. It's the right direction. Okay. Should make this. There's no reason for me to go diagonally up this way. I should just go straight. Yeah, that's better. So we have a few issues. Once again, a zombie not in a good spot. At least we've got a solid core here in the middle, but we have, as always, these one or two stragglers that are just gonna struggle. I think with her, I'm gonna go after the other hero. Just move up here. The Overwatch is annoying, but if I can lock him down up there, it's gonna be valuable. And potentially we can get a second unit on here and even be able to attack him. He won't be able to disengage, so he needs to switch his weapon. I'm okay with this. And it's two heroes that we're focusing on right now. Good, good. No stun, unfortunately, but the crit is still good. Okay, nice, nice, nice. And Web of Steel. We'll see how it'll play out. Agmundur now is interesting because he might be able to help my leader if I can navigate these rooms. Okay, I'm on the first floor. Or I'm on the upper floor. Let's call it that. Yeah, nice. Okay, we're down here. There is another enemy over there that is in an ambush stance as well, I believe. So we are going to go for their leader here. The issue, once again, is if I spellcast something now, and we blow up, it's going to hit my own leader as well. Flare could be worse, but I like the idol there, especially since it hit all three of them. Okay, he dodged. I didn't deal any damage, but at least his dodge is gone, and I get to Web of Steel. Could be worse, I guess. Big question, who do we hit? I think I'm gonna focus on their leader, but also with that, we insult. A wall cry is not really worth it. We're just gonna hit one of ours, and that's not good enough. I might even insult Greg. Not sure if that's gonna help us in any way. But I do have the strategy points left for that, because I don't have Web of Steel on him yet. Yeah, we don't. Okay. So we're gonna insult there as well. And then I'm gonna parry. He is, I think, the one that's the most in danger right now. Okay, and now it's, yeah, six enemies. We all know them. Okay, of course they moving right there, and I'm failing my parry. Oh boy. Yeah, this is, I need to get in there with all the others. They're close, but him having six guys in a row is scary as hell. Good miss. At least, yeah, his hit chance is horrible. Okay, wow, he missed with everything. This is good. If the drag repeats that, the issue... Ooh, wow. The drag will only attack our leader. He has no other target, and he's carrying a two-handed weapon. That's gonna make the damage a lot worse. Oh, I managed to parry. I do not believe it. I even get to counterattack. Hey, hooray! Come on. Oh, yep, we ambush. Potentially okay, though. Just because she's in the doorway. Which means I should be able to get a second guy on there while she is blocking that. But I'm not too sure if that's an issue for her. Also, she has way too many attacks. Yeah, way too many attacks. Oh, boy. This is quite dangerous. I don't think we're gonna get out of this without losing anybody. The issue... Oh, good. And did he charge? No, he did not charge. Okay, if he had charged, he only would have gotten one attack. We're still alive, though, so that's good. But that's not gonna stay that way. We're gonna go down. It's just I can't go in there right now. I need to keep attacking him. Oh, come on! Why again? That's what I get for trying to make this work. we just need for him to die or have to check for All Alone again and not do anything else. We do have a chance to kill him. If my charge had hit, he already would be dead. But he didn't, but now he's down, so that's good. Okay, next big question. Do I go into here? If I do that, nobody else will be able to, and we have all these guys over there. So I guess I'm moving her. It's a joke, isn't it? Usually there's always a broken link somewhere, but of course today there isn't. So I cannot get easily around the corner, and that just means we're gonna go in here after all. And try to go help our poor little guy over there, but the zombies are still too slow to really have an impact. least this one is. Makes his terror test, that's bad. Misses, he only has a 42% hit chance. That's not too good. One hit, shouldn't get more than two attacks at least. Okay, we're still kicking. Once again, dangerous position to be in. But I hope it'll work out. I'm focusing on her, she's worth more. She's not in an ambush stance, or not in a dodge stance apparently. I'm still very much under the impression that we're gonna die here. He's not looking too good, he's got 3 hit points left. Yeah, insult us, you do that. Lifestealer is also okay. Recovering 8 wounds for him. Yeah, sure, you do that. He's mind numb. That's probably preventing spell casting or something like that. Good parry. And that should be it. There we go. If I disengage with him, that's the issue. I'm not sure I can get down here in time to really do anything. So I'm gonna keep hitting the zombie and keep missing the zombie. The issue is, if I kill the zombie, it won't even help us that much because he does not impact morale at all. So I guess we do want to disengage and run away and see if I can find a better target. If I had done that right away, I just realized that I also might have just been able to outrun him completely, which now won't be the case. We've got that zombie over there now. Let's just try. Nope, I can't get in there. Okay, I'm going to go here, just because it... No, I put myself in a corner there. I won't be able to get away if that happens. Yeah, I'm going right here. This should allow me to disengage if somebody attacks us, like this zombie. That's what happens, okay. I hope I will be able to disengage from there. If not, at least it keeps this zombie away from running around and attacking somebody he's not supposed to. It's not... hitting Uncle Fester is not good, necessarily, but at least he can take the damage right now. Can I... Where is he? Oh, yeah. Can I... We cannot get in there. So this is pretty much locked down, and I just have to hope that whatever is in there will be enough to deal with it. I cannot really afford to loot. I guess I'm gonna make my way up there. Once we have a 2-on-1, it's gonna be a lot better. And he's just gonna move towards the leader. Or not the leader, the hero and the ghoul over there. So we have these two zombies at least to maybe do something. Yeah, I'm not a fan of how this is progressing right now. We've taken down one. We are going to lose the Liberator's Boon buff any moment. And they're gonna get their 6 actions in a row again. Very soon. Yeah, okay, I shouldn't have brought the ghoul over here. It's not necessary. He's gonna die without further issues, I think. Good, we succeed our terror test. I'm so tempted to try and blow ourselves up. You know what? Let's delay. Let's give our leader his action first. Are they still insulted? They are not. Also, the question is, who do we focus on? Probably him. But now the war cry should be worth it. Yeah, okay. It's better at least. If I insult now, I won't be able to parry, so we can't. I should not hit him, I think. Yeah, I'll keep attacking here with everything that I have. Just the big question. How do we do this now? Idol of Pestilence. Oh, I'm still flared. So spellcasting chance is pretty bad. What does this do again? Oh, yeah, it's damages and reduces armor absorption. I guess this turn I am just going to attack. It's four attacks. I wanted to say if I hit with all of them, we might have a chance. But we missed with the first one already. And even if we hit with all of them, I don't think it would have been enough. Yeah. It's even worse that we're just so close. But now our leader is gonna go down. Yeah, this is good. If the ghoul focuses on her, I'm okay with that. Ah, there it is. That's the parry. And that's where the counterattack is not supposed to go. It's still damaged, so it's good, but I don't like this. Our leader is gonna go down. Yes, attack him. Attack Agmundur. Keep doing that, please. Don't turn around. No! Turn around again. Come on. Thank you. You will get one more, maybe? Yep. Ah, come on. Now the Drek needs to miss with both of his, and I don't think that's going to happen. I hate this. I hate this. All, everything. All of it. With a passion. parry. Good. Come on. Crit. Nope. Miss? Now she's gonna take... Oh, actually a miss. She has two more attacks, though, so she's gonna take me down. There it is. That did not go as planned. Yeah, come down here. Let me charge you. Good. Okay, this is fine, though. I don't like that he went down and then morale... Maybe? No, that didn't went back up. We're still okay here. And I get my counterattacks. We have a chance to kill her this turn, I think. Yeah, stupidity check works. Okay, yep, yeah, now their morale is back. He recovered the idol. And he's gonna move down here. Now this is weird, because now we have two one-on-ones here. I would have liked to... Good. I would have liked to get both of the zombies on her, but that's not going to work now. And now I'm crit stunned as well. Oh boy. Yeah, there's not really anything else I can do here. It's so bad. Well, it's only bad because he dodged again. I know I'm full of complaints right now. And I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing. Probably a bad thing, if you think about it. If only I could get somebody else in there, but we can't. And yeah, he's just in the awkward middle spot that he can not go anywhere, really. Yeah, this is a crappy situation to be in. Okay, there's another zombie that now that I've... Oh, that's the zombie, one of the guys we need to kill. I don't think we're going to make the optional work, by the way, in case you were wondering. We do see all of the targets, and we're actually killing all of the targets as well, but we have other issues to concern ourselves with. Like this middle part here. Yeah, I'm just not going to do anything with him. I don't think it's going to be worth it to run him around there. It's going to take too long for him to get over there. By then, we already have two others up here that will be able to help. And secure this part for us. It's the middle where they are. That's bad. It's too late once again for the death stench, but better late than never. All the weird stuff. Makes his terror test again. Please tell me he misses twice. No. Ah. So this is where I get salty at the RNG, and of course he loots my weapons. Ah, crap. Because this is not something that usually happens. It's I'm missing my high percentage hit chances here, and they are just he hits with at least one of his attacks, even though the hit chances aren't that good. He makes his terror test twice in a row that was below a 40% chance, I think, to work. And if just something of that had not gone the way it did, my leader would still be alive. And now, of course, I Fema all alone. Hey, look at that. I have enough room to disengage. Who would have thought? That's only what I wanted, but now I don't. And now this is all just turning bad. I'm putting myself in the bad corner where I don't want to be in. But there's just nothing I can do about it. And this is annoying sometimes with more time. And I try to work with it, and it's always about risk management and prioritizing stuff, but there's so many influences here that it's just not always possible to really make this work. And that's what I don't like sometimes. Okay, he went down. And I did that on purpose so that I have all of her attacks left over for the area over here that she should be able to reach without too many issues. Yeah. And in the end, it probably still evens out, but the point, basically the single events are sometimes what would get me. And I don't know. Ooh, is that an active trap? I hope not. Okay. Can I even get her? I thought she had less hit points left than she did. Yeah, I need to make all of my hits. Yep. If I miss with the last one, she's gonna survive. Good, I didn't. Okay, so this worked out. Then we're gonna go in and attack this one. Oh, I should have parried. This is I've talked about it last time already. It defaults me to the wrong one, not the one that I want it to be. I'm gonna reset the idol, hit these two, and now if I blow up, it should only hit the leader and the ghoul, so I'm okay there. Might as well go for the spiteful manifestation as well. I want something to happen. There we go. That's more damage again. And that's it. Okay. Maybe could have been better if I had done it differently, but I think I'm okay with the way it went. I hate that my leader went down, and I hope nothing too bad will come of that. But we'll also have to wait and see about that. Ugh. Yeah, I think that was the main instance in this mission that rubbed me the wrong way here. It's not how it should even out, I think, and at least in my opinion. My opinion doesn't count for much in this regard, as we all know. It is what it is. It's not like I can change something, but it at least gives me something to complain about here. So let's see. That's the zombie that we need to kill. Don't know where that is. Yep, I assume this guy would show up as well. Now I don't have an all alone anymore right there, so the ghoul will get to do his attacks. That's a bummer. We knew that this zombie was there right from the start. He just didn't show up, luckily, until now, but this is also where I don't understand the timing again. Why does he show up now? And not earlier? It does not quite make sense to me. Yeah, I regret this as well right now. Okay, he missed. This should keep us alive. I did this mainly so that they can't get an all alone over there. Let's see what we can do here. The way he just went in there, the ghoul, completely... Oh, come on. Why? I know I'm getting very whiny right now. But just the way all of this plays out, it's completely blocked. I cannot get more than one unit in there. This is so bad. So I'm gonna delay with him this for now, at least. Not that it's gonna change much, I think. Yeah, we're gonna go after the ghoul. Okay, what's their morale at? It's not like they're very far away or anything. We're looking okay in terms of morale. Yeah, this is now. He might kill Uncle Fester. Vital strike. Okay, we're still alive. I will have to check for All Alone again. I hope I won't be able to disengage in case I fail. Otherwise, they're just gonna kill me. All Alone success. Okay. And this is what I was hoping for. Well, not really. Yeah, it does not help us at all. So I'm just gonna spellcast and buff and hope that that we get them before they get to attack him again. So now I can call up Van Helder Zombie. That's helpful. And I think I mastered it in the meantime. Oh no, I can't risk a counterattack. That would kill him. Yeah, I'm just gonna parry. I hate this. I hate this. I hate everything. Yeah, I think we do have the mastery of that now, which will allow me to get a lot further. And it might maybe allow me to get him into the fight. If only I could have made it around that quicker. Oh, wow. That charge range. That's a surprise. But I'm going to back off again and try to go the other way around. That might allow me to make it. Can get around. Yeah, this is what I needed. And it's not enough, so I lied. So I need to back off again and go back around the other side. But now, the way the game works, this suddenly does not work anymore. I don't understand this. Can somebody explain this to me, please? How this works out? Why I can move in, I cannot move back. It doesn't let me. And I don't get this. It does not make sense. So if I had hit with both of those, I know, utopic, it's a new concept that I'm trying to field test here, hitting with everything. We could have killed him. That might have dropped their morale. I don't think so, but they also had their idol left on him. And I need to loot that to get it. And if I had hit with the ghoul, both of attacks, he would have gone down. So that didn't happen. I need to be able to loot him. I hope that the zombie that has his turn now can loot that. But it's blocked. Yeah, it's not gonna happen. Yeah, we're just gonna do this. We can still make this work, at least this turn, that's what I'm getting at. With Akmundur going next now, he can kill their leader. He does have the capabilities. What I have to say about this is that he is making all of his all-alone checks. And that's not something you can just not his all-alone checks, his tarot checks. And that's not something you can just expect to happen. So I'm happy that it did happen. If I get at least a little bit out of it. Wow, it's a fragment. This should have dropped their morale low enough, though. Yes, that was quite the drop. And then we can attack here. With all three attacks, we were getting him close. This should be fine now. If they make one route check, it gets dangerous again. But if they don't, we're good. They will go first again now. They get to check. Please tell me they fail.
A new round has started.
Oh no, I get to go first. Okay. This might put them at zero as well. Not quite, they're at eight. She cannot loot. Yeah, I'm just gonna do this. Give them a different target to hit in case it's necessary. Not that I hope that it will be, but it might be. So let's see about that now. They failed their autotest. Okay, good. Good, good, good. We made it work. Still, two went down.
It is by
zombie is not too bad. It was a zombie, wasn't it? Manifest. But our leader is your potentially your problematic. To
when the legions of Sylvania march
with exceptional
on the mortals,
scavenge points, we might maybe at least get forgotten. A few good things out of this in terms of items.
The gods are with
you. 9 for recovery, but he lost his stuff. Yep, of course. Why not? And he lost his weapon as well, so that sword is gone. And he does not even rank up for that. Ugh, I don't like this.
Outstanding. Fantastic. Fantastic.
No, it's not fantastic. You're lying. And as always, I don't get good stuff. This is really something that's starting to annoy me with the undead. It's just that I don't get good weapons. It's so rare that I get them, and by now I should have mostly purple stuff. And it's just not showing up. Or am I completely wrong here? I might be. Let me take a look at the higher source. We do have a rank 5 leader, but I don't want to. He's healthy, but I think we're going to live with the handicap of him being one-armed. Please tell me I at least still have a blue sword left. Yeah, wow. Enervation. That's so useful. Let's do this as well. Give him this heavy armor. Oh boy. Well, he has some time to think about what he has done here. So for now, this is the end of today's episode, I guess. I hope you enjoyed it. And my suffering and my annoyance and my whininess. I apologize for that, by the way. So if you still enjoyed that, please leave a like in the comment, and if you want to see me play more time, just stick around. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you will tune in next time, and have a nice day. Bye!